Welcome to Recon Boot. It's Basil here with an Oculumia 620 and Oculumia 720, and we're comparing both of these gorgeous Windows phones for you. The Lumia 620 comes in at just £150 pay as you go here in the UK, and the Lumia 720 around double that, £250 to £300. But what's the difference? Well, kicking off with design, you can see the unibodied chassis on the Lumia 720 looks a lot richer. The Lumia 620 is fun, don't get us wrong, but it doesn't feel quite as classical. The curved glass, really, really gorgeous styling on the Lumia 720, really make it come into its own and almost make it feel like a successor to the ever, ever classical Nokia Lumia 800. 4.3-inch display on the fascia, 3.8-inch display on the Lumia 620. Three capacitive buttons directly below each. The Nokia Lumia 720 packs a micro SD eject tray on the left side. No buttons or ports on the left side of the Lumia 620. Right side, all the phones have the same buttons. And that's a volume rocker power button and two-stage camera button. Down below, micro USB port. Up top, 3.5mm headphone jacks. You've also got a micro SIM eject tray on the Nokia Lumia 720. As far as the displays go, you can really, really clearly see. It's much, much more vibrant on the more impressive on the Lumia 720. Even though it's larger and it's going to be slightly less sharp with the same resolution across both devices, the screen looks more superficial, much more like that gapless technology we've seen from HTC. The Lumia 620 display looks unfortunately a little bit more recessed. Having said that, still for the price point, it is incredible, just £150. Flipping the phones round, you've got cameras on both with flashes, 5 megapixels on the 620, 6.7 megapixels on the 720, and an f1.9 aperture. There is a removable back cover on the Nokia Lumia 620. As you can see, you've got that inner lining, which is pretty sweet. You've got micro SIM tray and micro SD expandability. Taking a look inside the actual phones themselves, and don't know what's going on there. Taking a look inside the phones themselves, and you've got Windows Phone 8 in spades. Nokia overlay Windows Phone 8 with their applications, or at least pump them inside. They include Nokia Here Maps, Here Drive, and Nokia Music. Here Maps is mapping services, akin to Google Maps, but it's Nokia's Navtech powered maps. Here Drive is really, really cool. GPS and sat-nav functionality. You've got Here Drive Plus on the Lumia 620, oddly. So that gives you world maps for your sat-nav, unlike the Lumia 720, which gives you maps for just the UK and Ireland. It's an odd one, but that's just how it is. Nokia Music gives you offline playlists for some fantastic music on the go, all curated by Nokia's music team in Bristol, and we visited and they do some pretty incredible stuff to make sure you just get the exact music that you want. So you should definitely, if you have a Windows phone with Nokia Music on it, check that out. So moving on to the UIs, as we said, Windows Phone 8, really predictable experience, and there's not much in it across both. As far as the performance goes, you've got 1 GHz dual core processors with 512 megabytes of RAM, and that's plenty to power everything along nicely. The cameras, as we said, 6.7 megapixel Carl Zeiss optics on the Lumia 720. We can take a quick picture, give you an idea of the performance. We can see a two-stage camera button in action. Immediately it used that focus assist lamp to pull focus. Focus is pretty nice and quickly, can take a shot really easily, and boom, there you go, you've got a pretty decent shot there. What real forte is of this, thanks to their 1.9 aperture, is the low light lens. We can see though the Lumia 620 doesn't have a bad camera at all. If we pull in focus, take a shot, slightly shaky hand, but we've still managed to get a decent shot. So whichever handset you go for, you're still going to get pretty decent imaging experience. And Nokia will make this better with Nokia's lenses, which work across both devices. All in all, therefore, you pretty much going to get the same experience inside the phone on both. As far as the design goes, it's really a Nokia 720 all the way. The Lumia 620 is more customizable, so may appeal to the younger crowd, and definitely is a rich, rich device, probably the richest device you can get for 150 quid. The 720 unibody though feels markedly richer, slender, but still feels very, very solid in the hand. So this has been Basil with Recombu comparing the Nokia Lumia 620 and the Nokia Lumia 720. If you have any questions about these devices, please feel free to fire us a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, click like, and if you like our channel, you know what to do, subscribe.